Oh, what is going on, everybody?
Hey!
It is Pixel Partners here, and welcome to Apollo with Justice Ace Attorney.
Apollo with Justice.
What, you thought we were done after HD Trilogy? No.
Nope.
We're going to continue in the game series by going back in time, technically, to where things are not as refined as they were in that trilogy just now.
No.
Get used to looking at things in 720p, even though it's less than 720p. All right.
Back in 2007, I was in high school.
Yeah, I actually...
I was a sophomore in high school in 2007.
I thought... Well, let me see. If I graduated
No. Wait, seven.
You were a freshman. I was in eighth grade.
I was a freshman?
So you were a freshman.
But I graduated in 2010.
It depends on which part of the school you were talking about. Anyways, let's stop talking about us and go to a new game. I forgot my TV's still fucking loud.
I was a teenager. I'm not anymore.
Oh, no. All right,
so
we're going to start our lovely adventure. I just realized my mouse is on screen. We're going to go ahead and move that quick. Go ahead and fill the gap for me, please.
Okay. Well, we have this lovely sepia-colored... Is it sepia or sepia?
I think it's sepia.
Someone tell me in the comments how you pronounce it.
I think it's sepia.
Okay.
Anyways, now that I'm back being a professional, I thought I'd move that away before, but now we're back in this, and we're going to play Episode 1, Turnabout Trump. This game is ahead of its time, ladies and gentlemen. I hope it's not about anything like that. So we're just going to go ahead and hit the go button and play Turnabout Trump.
Seizure warning.
Episode 1, Turnabout Trump.
Look, it's a movie. Okay, we got an artist.
They've drawn.
They signed it. Blew out a candle.
Ooh. Whoa. They lifted their budget
lamp.
A little bit.
We got
a playing card?
Yeah.
Looks like playing cards.
Oh, they're playing cards. With playing cards.
Showdown time. Y'all both cheating? That's some hefty hands. You lose.
Ugh! Oh, damn.
A bottle. Eek!
Oh. Someone just got murdered. Myrtled.
Got myrtled?
Got myrtled.
A phone's ringing.
Hello?
I seem to be in a bit of trouble. Something like that. Dead. Someone hit him. Hard. Me? Please. Cops should be here any minute. I'm in your hands. Should it come to that?
Huh.
Okay. Whatever you say, dog.
Weird.
Oh, man.
Oh, wow.
That looks
weird.
A little different. Has the picture of the judge always been there? Because that also looks really weird.
No, that's different. It used to be a landscape.
Okay. All right.
Nope.
Apollo, I got to get in this.
Palm sweaty. Knees weak.
Oh, God. Okay, so I remember her and I talked about this off camera.
Yeah.
Because I can't do the regular me voice. Because
that's
Phoenix.
Just Phoenix.
That's Phoenix.
Yeah.
I was Phoenix. Phoenix is me.
He is.
And maybe Apollo's me too. I don't know. Maybe I'm a morphing of these two motherfuckers. I don't know. So my thought process is, if I can hold on to it somehow, and I haven't had any warm up for it, I'm going to try and make Apollo be me, but more Funimation style, more super duper English dub. If I can do it, I've got to try and get.
But you're gonna be playing a whole series with that. What, you're gonna die?
I'm also gonna try and raise my voice up a little bit, as if I was a little younger.
I was gonna say because he's a younger boyo, isn't he?
I think so. I have no idea. I don't know his details. We'll probably find out soon. But
from the one picture I've seen of him, he looks like a kid.
Probably.
But I don't know.
I don't know. We'll see. Okay.
Oh, God.
Panicked. Palms sweaty. I can admit it. I'm nervous.
It's like a younger Phoenix. Don't know.
Good morning.
Oh, that works.
That works for you.
Yeah, it does.
Good morning, sir. You look tense, Justice. Wound up tight. Wound up, sir? No, I'm loose. I'm fine.
I got you.
That screeching noise. Is that your voice? I suppose it's to be expected.
That actually kind of worked.
Your first trial and it's a homicide, I guess. Justice doesn't start small, huh?
Oh my God.
I'm fine. I got up at 5 a.m. to do a Cords of Steel voice workout. I'm fine.
Cords of Steel?
That explains it. I did detect a certain rasping quality to your screech. I overdid it again.
cords, like buns of steel, but with your vocal cords.
As you know, your client today is a good friend of mine. I wouldn't want to let him down, if you get my drift. Drift gotten, sir. I'm all over that drift.
What a dork.
As it happens, I dined with him the night of the murder.
Oh.
We can't let this case fall through. Yes, yes, I'm fine, sir.
Okay.
One more thing. Don't say you're fine quite so much. People might take you the wrong way. I'm preparing our case. You might want to introduce yourself to the client.
What in the world?
Our client. My name is Apollo Justice. If it isn't clear already, I'm a new attorney.
Yeah.
And today is my first trial.
You don't say.
Not that I'm worried or anything. The defendant has been accused of murder. My boss wants me to help him out, of course. And so do I. I mean, there's no way he did it. Not him. No way.
Okay. Whoa.
Okay.
Dude with a kind of cool looking beanie.
Why is your beanie screaming? Ah! Okay. Whoa.
Okay.
Good morning.
Okay.
Morning. It's all up to you today. First trial. Nervous. Meeting him. Cardiac arrest.
What?
I think I'm supposed to say something?
Help!
So you're... Fine! I'm fine!
God, what the fuck?
Mr. Fine, is it?
Oh my god.
I didn't remember you having an odd name. Well, we're off to a great start.
Apollo's such a dork! Oh my god!
Are you sure you're okay? I mean, with me? Mr. Gavin is a top-notch defense attorney. And he's your friend, so why... You'll see.
Huh?
You can do it. Be confident. I'm really sorry this happened to you. I mean, it's time. Shall we? Yes, sir! Okay, I need to focus. First trial. Here comes justice.
Oh my god!
Okay, they ain't letting me down. They ain't letting me down so far. You and me, dog, I'm hitting off at you, okay?
I feel you. Oh my god. Oh Jesus, who was that? Hey!
Yeah, welcome back.
At least there's one constant in this.
Yeah.
The court is now in session. Oh god.
Oh my god, what the
it's
fuck
pain.
Happened to you?
He decided to grow his hair out, but he can't grow it on top because he's balding, so he grew the rest of it out, and it does not look
that
good.
That is horrifying.
He looks like a freaking kappa.
Horrifying. The prosecution's ready, Your Honor.
That is unfortunate. Whoa.
The defense is, fine. I mean, ready, Your Honor.
I'm fine.
Mind going blank. Don't panic. Too late.
Oh my god. Your name was Mr. Justice. This is your first trial.
I mean, I might be All Might, but I'm not sure yet.
Brunette All Might.
Like, dude, you got the All Might hair going on.
Young brunette All Might. Yeah.
Yes, Your Honor. But I'm fine. Really.
Are you quite sure? The voice sounds a bit strange. Mr. Gavin?
Yes, Your Honor.
I was under the impression that you would be heading up this case.
That was my intention, yes. However... A defense attorney must always accede to his client's wishes. And my client specifically requested Mr. Justice.
Well, of course he wants justice. But to address this case to this greenhorn, why? Do not exaggerate when I say that you're the best defense attorney in town, Mr. Gavin.
Okay, so Gavin's got trial experience, fine. But does he have cords of steel?
Oh my god.
And let's begin. The defendant may enter the courtroom.
Oh boy.
All right.
Dots.
It's truly unfortunate turn of events. Sorry I had to meet again under these circumstances. Long time no see, Mr. Wright.
What?
What?
Whoa. Excuse me?
Wait. You okay, dog?
Wait.
You...
What? Eh? Nani?
Let's put the past behind us, shall we?
What?
These days I'm merely Phoenix Wright. Piano player.
He plays
Mr. Wright, how could this have happened?
I won't speak of it further then. The prosecution will be so kind as to explain the charges, Mr. Payne.
To think I saw you enter this room a fresh attorney.
and now I'll see you leave in chains. Ah, Winston Payne. Subtle as ever, I see.
What the fuck?
Well, that was a weird turn of events. Ahem! The crime occurred in the Borscht Bowl Club, a Russian restaurant. The defendant, Phoenix Wright, took the victim, a customer, and he hit him. Wham on the head, smack killed him cold.
A customer at the restaurant, you say?
Gonna say quick, I'm kind of digging this trial music so far.
Yeah.
It's actually kind of relaxing in a way, but also dramatic still in a way.
Uh-huh.
I like it. It's fresh. I dig it.
Whoa, his face. That's very different from what I'm used to.
I think that's his surprise expression in low poly count.
It looks like his eyelids are super, like, his, like lower eyelids are super pushed up. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, okay.
The defendant, you say he was...
The pianist for the club, it seems.
Phoenix Wright? A pianist?
This is the weapon that took the victim's life. A bottle of grape juice. Class, I see. Grape juice appear on the odd defendant's drink of choice.
The court accepts a deadly bottle as evidence.
Okay, deadly bottle out of the court record.
Okay.
I've got to figure out how to use the court record because I'm on a controller right now, so I've got to figure out how the fuck this is going to work.
Yeah.
Something to note, Justice. All evidence is filed in the court record.
Filed.
Fuck. Make a practice of checking it frequently. The court record? Right, I've heard of that.
You've heard of that?
Use the court record button to look at the evidence so far. I'm confident in your ability to handle this. Let me see if I have any one of these buttons. Y? X? R? R. Okay, that'll do it for me. Okay.
Testing, right. Testing.
Our attorney's three. Badge? Can I check that? How long do I yearn for one of these? Just betting on me makes me feel ready.
Okay.
Right. What next? All right. Smith's autopsy report. Time of death was around 2 a.m.
2 a.m. Wow.
Guess death caused by a single blow to forehead. Okay. Crime photo. The sub basement at the Borscht Bowl Club. The
Borscht Bowl Club. Borscht Bowl Club.
Touch check button for details. Check it.
Whoa.
Okay. It's kind of small because it's on the bottom screen for you guys. It's really difficult to edit this, but
yeah.
It's a picture. He's there. There's a bottle. Not getting much else from it right now.
Nope.
So, okay. Good deals. All right, let's progress
now.
Okay. Right. The court record button. Sounds like it's time for some real hands-on action.
You still kind of sound like Phoenix when you said that.
Well, I'm sorry.
You up your voice a little bit.
I'm trying my best here.
So the victim was a customer at this restaurant, but just who was this Shady Smith fellow?
Or I think it's supposed to be Shady.
Shady
this game,
Smith.
Shady Smith.
Yeah.
Of course.
Even though it's like spelled like it should be said shoddy, but whatever.
Shady Smith.
We believe he was a traveler, Your Honor.
A traveler?
According to his passport, he has been out of the country for a number of years. He only returned to the country recently, though his place of residence is unclear.
There's some sort of connection with the defendant.
That too is unclear at the present, Your Honor. We believe they first met at the Borscht Bowl Club on the night of the crime.
If they'd only just met, then why murder? Perhaps the victim slighted the defendant's piano playing?
That doesn't appear to have been the case. No, the motive had nothing to do with the defendant's lack of playing skill. At least not piano playing. I'll let this photo explain what I mean. Now they put on the big
yeah.
one for you guys. As we can see, a game of poker was in progress at the scene of the crime.
It's like James Bond.
Wait a second! Isn't poker gambling? That's a crime in and of itself!
Oops. In some places, yeah, it is. Indeed, it appears our defendant has fallen to become the basest sort of criminal.
Hmm.
It is true that the defendant was engaged in a game of poker with the victim. Yet it was only that. A game in the purest sense. A competition, Your Honor.
A competition?
Yes, a test of wits, a sudden clash of passion. Only the cards that backs wreathed in blue flame know its final outcome.
Come again?
The cards on the table are blue backs, Your Honor. I believe the defense was waxing poetic. Waxing poetic in an attempt to mystify those present. And impress women.
That will be our first order of business here, then. To find out more about this fatal game of cards and women.
Smirk he has. I don't know how I feel, but he looks a lot tanner than I remember, too.
He's fallen from grace.
Yeah.
Very well, defendant. You will testify to the court about the poker competition held the night of the crime.
My pleasure. This is it. My first trial. Here goes nothing.
Oh my god.
All right. Competition.
He looks all so right. different.
I mean, it looks like he's fallen from grace a little bit, so...
Yeah, what the hell happened?
I don't know.
What's that locket around his neck? Who gave that to him? So many questions.
For real. I'm a pianist by trade. You can hardly play at all. My real job is to take on interested customers over at the poker table.
Huh.
The room where we play in the competition... The club's main attractions. The rules are simple. We play a game of poker using two decks of cards.
Okay.
That's all it is. A game. And our customers are happy.
Huh.
A pianist who can't play a piano?
But in a defense attorney, you can't defend.
Ow.
Oof. Big oof. Very well. The defense may begin the cross-examination.
Right, Your Honor. My first cross-examination. Don't blow it. Are you all right? You're sweating bullets.
Bullets? Where?
Oh my god.
It's a figure of speech, Justice. Your voice sounds strained and raspy, too.
My brain feels strained and raspy, sir.
You've watched me perform cross-examinations many times. They've never done one yourself, have you? Care for a refresher?
What to do? Can I ask Mr. Gavin for a refresher course in cross-examination?
That thinking face, I like it. We remember, unless anything's different, which I...
Huh. Just in case, refresher
yeah.
course.
Yeah.
Better safe than sorry, especially this early in the game.
Wow, it's like they know us.
Yes, teach me. I know nothing. Indeed.
Indeed, Jon Snow.
Your job, Justice, is to be mindful of the court record and the testimony. Look for inconsistencies in the testimony of what the court record tells you. When you've found an inconsistency, that's when you present the conflicting evidence from the court record.
Okay, yeah, so it's just stuff we know.
But I didn't hear anything strange in the testimony, strange at all in the testimony just now.
Wow, he really can't.
A good sign that you need to press the witnesses more information.
Press him? Like a button?
Don't let the fact that he's a remarkable man hold you back. Get more information.
But isn't Mr. Wright my client?
Well, I think you can do it.
Yes, thank you, sir. I think I can do it.
I think you'd better, or we're going to have a problem.
Yeah.
Just remember, find any inconsistencies, any lies in the testimony, and reveal them to the court. That is cross-examination. Learn it, know it, do it.
Do it.
Inconsistencies. Lies. Phoenix Wright.
As if Phoenix Wright would never lie, and it's up to me to prove it.
The defense may begin the cross-examination.
Whoa, that's cool.
All right. Competition.
Okay.
Pianist by trade, and yeah, I can hardly play at all.
Press!
Okay, let me make sure I hit the right button, so it's the Y button, I believe. Do they want me to speak? Okay, I can do okay. that instead. Wise to go ahead and... I can say hold it, because the DS likes to work like
that. That's awesome! I want the game now!
I just wish you could do that and just scream.
Can you imagine just sitting on a bus and you're just sitting there, all of a sudden you go, hold it!
And the bus screeches to a halt.
And the person next to you is just like, what?
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Anyways, you can hardly play? Oh, I play sometimes when customers demand it. So I play them one song. That's usually all they want. Was that supposed to be a boast just now? A title of pianist is a mask. A respectable face I wear for the world at large.
Then why are you really at the Boast Bowl Club?
That is, the real job is to take on interested customers over at the poker table. Press. Then pay you just to play poker? That would seem to be the case. I am a professional, after all.
Professional poker player?
Do I take pride in that statement? It's just hard for an honest, hard-working member of society like me to imagine.
Yes. Your imagination was always a bit limited, Winston.
Oof. Yeah, what?
I've played poker for 7 years in that little room.
Jesus.
And I've never lost. Once.
Never lost.
What?
Once. Wow, okay.
You see why the customers come now? Defeat the undefeated poker champion. It's quite a draw. That is, quite a draw.
Wait, you've never lost once? Not even one time?
As I said, I'm a professional.
Huh.
He's played poker for 7 years and not lost once?
7 years,
is that even
wow.
possible?
So he's like around 33 or so now? He's like probably. He's like Godot's age when Godot became Godot.
Yeah, I guess. All right, so the room where they play is the main attraction.
I think.
The room with the crime scene photo is an attraction?
He's in his early 30s.
It has quite a history, actually.
I think.
The Borscht Bowl Club used to be a gathering spot for black market types back in the day. But black market? All in the past. Things like the black market are only on the silver screen nowadays. Somebody say there were a lot of deals being made under the table. Right there in that room.
A smoky room, gambling goods, you know. Just looking at this picture makes me feel bad.
The bosses gather around the table, cutting deals safe from the eyes of the law. Meanwhile, a goon helps watch through the small window.
You mean keeps watch?
Keeps watch. I can practically
he does help
it.
Too.
I can practically picture it now. That window does look like it would be good for keeping luck out, but little less. Little else. Fuck.
Talk! Read!
The room had a few other tricks to it. Though it was common knowledge to our regulars. At any rate, they come to play poker at the room steeped in history. Despite the dark past, it was all just good, clean fun. Rules are simple, we play a game of poker using two decks of cards. Two decks of cards? A simple measure to prevent cheating. If you alternate two decks, no one can slip in cards.
That makes sense.
There's something else I noticed. In addition to the cards on the table, there's some lying scattered on the floor.
Precisely, cards on the table, cards upon the floor, each one forming a complete deck. A crime scene painted blue by a sad sweep of cards. It's poetic, really.
Oh my god.
Incidentally, we used two types of cards at the club. One deck of cards was red, the other blue.
Like the Matrix! As I recall, in poker, you make five card hands. And see how it'd be easy to cheat?
Yes, game of hands. Nani?
What?
It's competition you're talking about. I believe the court understands the nature of the game sufficiently.
That's right! It was a simple game, after all.
Okay, are you sure?
Huh?
People are not murdered over simple games, Mr. Justice. Defendant? Were you in the room the very moment the crime occurred? You were in the room, yet you claim no connection to the crime?
Now that's strange.
What's strange?
I was testifying about the competition that night. Asking me about the crime at this point is against the rules, Your Honor.
Oof.
Of course, I expected to hear a cry of objection from the defense.
Oof.
I completely let that one slip by. Don't despair yet, Justice. Sir? Right. There's something I'd like to make clear. Namely, your connection to the case at hand. And I'd like to hear it from you. Sure, why not?
What the hell happened to him?
Very well, the defendant will amend his testimony.
Just one little press.
Of a button.
And I've got myself a whole new testimony. I plead silence regarding the murder. But I will say I never touched the murder weapon. Press it! Silence?
Plead the fifth.
The defendant has the right to refuse to testify. I haven't forgotten everything about the law. But why? That clearly puts you at a disadvantage. And it's your job to turn that around in our favor, yes?
Oh, damn.
Great, like I didn't have enough to do already. Justice, didn't you detect anything odd about that testimony? Huh? Wait, something you said didn't ring a little strangely. Just one thing. Then what was it? When you figure it out, I'd suggest presenting evidence. Evidence that contradicts the testimony. A contradiction, Mr. Wright's testimony? But why? I better check the court record. I can't imagine Mr. Wright lying in a testimony. Isn't it a little to be jumping to conclusions? This is your first cross-examination. Take it slow. If you need more information, don't forget to press. But right, I got it, I'm fine. Time to listen to that testimony again.
Sorry I'm being so quiet, I'm just absorbing all this. I'm just thinking, how the hell did he end up like this?
I guess we'll probably figure out over time.
You know what I mean? I'm just sitting here gawking at the situation here, and I'm just like, what the
okay,
fuck?
Okay, so...
He looks like a hoodlum!
Alright, what can I present? So... Okay, I don't want to present yet. I want to check this.
He looks so different. Like, granted, you know, the beanie hides his hair, which is his signature feature.
But oh, like, okay, that's what I figured.
What the hell, man?
I mean, whatever happened, I mean, he's had 7 years for things to go downhill, so...
Yeah.
Well, it would look like... this is our kind of trick to say he never touched the murder weapon, but Mr. Wright's fingerprints are all over this, yeah. So, present.
Yeah.
How do I present exactly? I'll figure out eventually.
Why?
Don't make me do that. I mean, I can... Oh, God, it's one of these.
Oh,
Oh, no, it's one of these. Oh, no, it's one of these.
Go back.
Examine the label. Grape juice. How long has it been since I drank grape juice? Apparently, it's Mr. Wright's favorite drink. I wonder how well it goes with borscht.
Oh, my God. Okay, back.
I can zoom in and out. I don't know how to rotate, though.
Go back. Okay. Why is present?
No, that's the speak.
Oh, to say it.
Objection!
Can you hit...
Objection!
Can you just hit the... Just hit, like, whatever select would be? After hitting Y, or...
Hang on, maybe I can...
Oh, God. We should have looked this up.
Here? Here? I can hit X for it.
There we go. Okay.
X will do it.
Jesus.
So you say you didn't touch the murder weapon. This grape juice bottle? Right?
Right.
So I said...
Something the matter, Mr. Justice?
Oh my god!
Never do that again. Never do that again. Never do that again. Never do that again.
Oh!
Too bad a new defense student never learned how to play dumb.
What's this, Mr. Payne?
I examined the bottle in question, you see. And it was covered with the defendant's fingerprints.
Oh,
they're chattering.
Objection!
No need to shout, Mr. Justice. I can hear you just fine.
Oops. Excess yelling can damage the judge's ears and our case. But what about my cords of steel?
Oh my god, what the...
Anyways!
This kid...
What's so strange about fingerprints on a ball in a restaurant?
Well, that's true. The prints alone don't prove...
They won't prove a thing. There were no more fingerprints.
Huh?
But the fingerprints on the murder weapon were upside down.
Upside down? What does that mean?
It means he was holding the bottle inverted. And there can only be one reason for that. Yes.
Oh my god, he did it again.
To brain someone with the bottle.
Oh no.
Oh, okay, that's funny. I like that. Very expressive. Much more expressive than
Phoenix. Mr. Gavin, I think things just took a turn for the worse. Oh? I see no problem, Justice. Huh? The only thing that matters is the truth. There's a good reason for everything. You'll see.
Defendant, can you explain your fingerprint on this bottle to the court?
I stand by my plea regarding my plea of silence regarding the murder. For now.
Not very cooperative, are you? It's gonna hurt your case.
I'm sure he's uncooperative because he's hiding something. There must be some reason.
Objection. Your Honor, I seem to have forgotten something.
And what might that be, Mr. Gavin?
On the night of the crime, who was it who reported the murder to the police?
Reported?
Well, that was the defendant, Mr. Wright. But still, Dad.
Really?
Yes, well, according to the case file. The murder was reported from near the scene by a call from the defendant's cell phone.
Near the scene?
Let's take a look at the diagram of the murder scene, shall we?
Oh boy.
The victim was waiting in a small room in the basement, two floors down from ground level.
Okay.
Of course, cell phones can't get reception so far down.
No.
The defendant used the stairs in this hallway to go above ground. The call came from the first floor restaurant.
I see! And this is the phone that made the call!
Right, cell phone.
He still has the same phone.
Yeah. The defendant could have just fled the scene of the crime if he so chose. Yet he fulfilled his duty as a citizen and reported it to the authorities. And you claim he's being uncooperative.
Nice save, Mr. Gavin. I'd better not waste this.
I think the prosecution has toyed with our client enough for the time being.
Toyed? I assured you no one is more serious about...
What was it you said? The defendant was in the room the very moment that the crime occurred? How can you possibly know this?
That's true.
That's a good question. How indeed?
The answer is simple, Your Honor. The prosecution has a decisive witness.
You're as good as they say you are. So someone else is in the room that night of the crime. It must mean they witnessed the crime.
Everything up until now has been a warm-up, Justice. Are you ready?
You're doing three voices at once, I just realized this.
It's a little interesting.
Very well, prosecution may call his first witness to the stand.
And we're gonna call them next time.
Man, this is different.
It is. It's gonna take a little bit of getting used to.
Yeah.
But I'm digging it so far.
Mm-hmm.